what I most like about the Technion and what I find most appealing is its incredible preservation of the academic environment and playing field. I see it as a pure meritocracy that's accessible to all without barriers which are cultural, religious, political, or otherwise. And I think that that's an academic space that's increasingly threatened, but particularly for an Israeli institution. And I say that coming from the United States, where there are more and more calls for a movement that would support the boycott and divestment of all engagement with Israel, including academics. When I visited Technion last year, that was largely because I knew of the global reputation of Technion, and also the president, Dr. Peretz Levy, is a sleep specialist. I hesitate to say fellow because I'm not in his orbit by any means, but I was very attracted to learn about an Israeli academic institution. At the time, calls to facilitate academic boycott against Israel were growing, and I was very concerned that there be no contraction of academic freedoms in particular to any colleague I had anywhere. I think it's very symbolic that Israel represents so many freedoms of expression and religious pursuit, which is unique in the Middle East region, with which I'm quite familiar. But academic freedom, the exchange of ideas and flow of information between peoples, is absolutely paramount. And that priority is very apparent when you visit Technion, even like me, for a very brief visit. So this is an, you would call it a basic research, bench research on animal cells, or anything we can do to foster closer bonds with the Israeli academic community, I think should be pursued, even though Israel is very connected to the United States and Western Europe already. There can never be enough of this kind of exchange. And that's not for the necessarily for the benefit of Israel, because Israel is accomplished extraordinary amount, having functioned in an effective regional boycott for over 65 years, and many global penalties by many nations. But the benefit, for instance, to my trainees in the United States or my colleagues, I think would be enormous. People are just not aware of not just what is being learned and developed here, but how the learning actually occurs and how the teaching actually occurs. I was honored to meet Technion's valedictorian, who is female, is a physician, is an Israeli, and is of Arab origins, and is a Muslim lady. So my time with her was very encouraging, particularly to hear about her upbringing, her family origins, her goals as a fellow professional, and her view on the future, which actually is a very bright one. The fact that she, number one, not only was awarded the valedictorian status, but was able to compete on a level playing field in one of the most academically elite environments, I found very gratifying. But I would feel the same about any valedictorian, whatever his or her gender or religion, because Technion is blind to those aspects of identity when it comes to academic accomplishment, but recognizes unique challenges as they arise. One of the things I learned from the medical students today in my meetings with the students and the vice dean was that there actually is a consideration when they divide medical students up into rotations for certain disciplines of the diversity of the group, so that no group is homogenous in any way, which they feel it promotes team building, and the students themselves inform is very helpful for the patients. Your academic environment, the way in which you lead your lives, practice your medicine, advance your science, build your technology, is an example in coexistence and collaboration that we need desperately globally. You have mastered the mechanism of collaborating across political, cultural, religious, and gender barriers. Very few organizations can say this. Not only have you mastered the collaboration, but you've reached an academic excellence which is virtually unrivaled, though I'm sure hotly contested. And so every individual who participates in Technion, whether it is the first year medical student or whether it is the president of Technion himself, has a huge responsibility to disseminate the how and the why of what you're doing. And I think that can be done in many media. It can be done when you are patenting an innovation. It can be done when you're accepting the care of a patient from the conflict zone in Syria, or it can be done in a blog post that a medical student might write, but it needs to be disseminated. That's the only attention the BDS movement deserves, is your continued success. Their argument I don't see as valid, and I therefore don't see that it deserves any kind of formal response, but your continued success, innovation, and the way you thrive is just what it needs to silence it.